Hey everybody, Combo Fiend here at the Mad Catz Cup Day 2. So today we have an exciting 8-man exhibition. I was a part of that exhibition. I declined the spot because I'd rather sit here and talk about how awesome 5 is rather than show it to you, because everyone who's going to participate today has been practicing pretty hard since they've been here. They've also been playing the betas, so they know what's up. I believe our first match that we have coming up in the Invitational is Gutex. Gutex versus Zeep. So yesterday, Zeep was a little rusty. Actually, not rusty, but he didn't know what was going on. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
And just when I thought,
oh, no,
we were going to have a professional set of commentary, it's that Mike Gross joins the fray.
The boys are back. So did you get a chance to see Filipino champs Delsum?
I saw him put in that work. Which way did he go, Mike?
Which way did he go? He's actually, he's very nimble right now. The man has some experience behind his belt under the Street Fighter V.
Yeah, you know, I was telling the stream that I could count the number of hours he's played on my two hands. You know, I have estimated it about 6 hours or so. You know, but yeah, Filipino champ doing the thing.
Yep.
Do you think he should be in this Invitational over you? Did he beat you for your spot?
Oh, sure. Go ahead. Yeah, let him have it.
No, I'm just kidding.
I'm about to say, yeah, do you really feel that way? Go ahead. Let him have it.
Hey, Mike, you're the, everybody wants to see you play, okay?
Okay.
So now we have Gutex coming up against Z. I am waiting for Z to show up. As I said yesterday, he looked a little rusty.
Yeah.
Not rusty, but actually uninformed.
Yes.
But I saw you showing him.
Yeah, just tried to show him some of the basic stuff to see if he could try to help him out with his characters that he was looking at, possibly Zangief or Ryu.
Yeah. So, I mean, I saw him picking up some stuff. He's understood a few combos. Of course, he understands jab.
Yeah.
SPD range.
Yep. Yeah, he's kind of got a good grasp on that now.
Yeah, and you see Ryan right there getting his hands hot.
Exactly.
He has the Shadaloo stick in his hands. Yep. He has the Shadaloo shirt on his body.
This man is ready to play some Street Fighter V.
Getting that damage ready. That's right, Ryan. Get feisty. Yeah. Ooh, okay, yeah. And, I guess they may have went to the restroom. Yeah. I mean, we could call another match.
Oh, I don't see him. Yes.
Yeah, I mean, you know, for the sake of getting this, knocking this baby out, we could just get another match, because I'm sure Ricky is just aching to play Justin.
Should we have them go next, or go right now?
Why don't we just have Ricky versus Justin right now? Why don't we get them to play?
Alright, never mind.
Oh, okay.
Seglia's on the scene.
We were just told, I got this. I got this. Actually, sorry, that was a bad twist.
That's okay.
But if you ever hear the voice, Chris Seglia himself,
the god.
Extremely raspy. So, do you know who I put in for my spot?
Who'd you put in for yours? Oh, you. Who did you put in? You didn't.
I put in the guy who plays almost as wild as I do. Untamed.
PR Rock?
Nah, LPN. I put in the guy who looks like me.
I see.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Well done.
Alright, and here comes Z. Man, Z is dressed oh so wild.
To perfection. That's what he does.
The amount of colors
on that man right now.
And, you know, Ryan going with the Mika pick. You know, it confuses me that he keeps going with this. Like,
why does it startle you? What is?
I'm just startled by it because I feel like Ryan has a pretty solid Ryu, and that's who he's put in a lot of time with.
Yeah.
I mean, he's played a lot of the characters in the betas. You guys have seen him putting in hours. Check out his stream archives. But it's like Mika in this version is not the same Mika that he got really, really good with.
Right.
Mika has seen some changes between builds, and those changes do not favor him.
Exactly.
So,
and some of the stuff, Z does not look like he's ready for the defensive end.
Yeah, you taught him some combos but not how to block.
Yeah, exactly.
Nice. Mike Ross. The school of Mike Ross, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, no.
Yes.
But to
be
fair, that strategy gets a lot of early game Street Fighter V players is the neutral jump in the corner. We saw Justin doing it at E3. You know, all over the place.
So yeah, neutral jumping. So the reason why that works for those of you who are watching and you're wondering, how does somebody neutral jumping cause the other guy to press throw?
Right, right.
Well, the reason for that is that in Street Fighter 4, whenever there is a pause, you have to push light punch and light kick to throw.
Yeah.
So what's happening is there's a pause and people say, oh, there's a pause. He must be going for a throw.
Right.
And then they just commit. And in this game, there's no option selecting. So if you press it, that's what you get. So when you push throw and you guess wrong, you get ate up. And that's what's happening here, guys. Oh, and look at that. Giving those kicks.
Yes. Oh, is he going to get it? Yes, he is. It's going to be some big damage here.
And just burying Mika into the cement. And there it is again. Bad habits die hard.
Yes.
Bad habits die hard.
That neutral jump is just completely, completely exposing him right now.
Go take the bus, you.
Are we doing 2 out of 3?
We are doing 3 out of 5. No, 2 out of 3.
Two out of three.
Yeah. Man, wow, I feel like the production team here is a little hostile, guys. You guys are
sending some threats over here.
Whoa, I mean, the speed at which the hand signals are flying? Man, I thought that they were performing ninjutsu over here. So, anyhow.
There we go. So he's going to go with Ryu. He did not like the way Zangief was feeling. Might have better luck here with Ryu. I want to see lots of buttons in this matchup.
Oh, if you want to
more
see,
activity.
If you want to see buttons, there's somebody who will be on the scene a little later for that, to quench that need. Oh, it's sliding under the hurricane kick. Those beta tactics.
Yeah.
Oh, and Ryan didn't go for the command throw. He could have got it there. Oh, footsies.
Yes.
Those are literal footsies.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, and Ryan playing a little defensively.
Oh, and Z has now learned a little bit about the importance of corner pressuring in this game.
Oh, no! Don't backdash! That's a counter hit state! And the game decided to save a video clip because that was too real. And the Deshko falling from the sky, keeping Z in place.
Ooh.
Oh, that's standing fierce. Please activate the trigger on the action. Wow, and Ryan picking the wrong attacks. Z looking like he might take this round. Okay. Faster fireballs.
Oh, wow. Oh, no. And Z drops it.
And Z
could have closed it.
Z had a fantastic read. The neutral jump? That was very intelligent.
Yep. Ryan thanks the Street Fighter V gods on that one.
And the mic performance. Ryan mistiming it. You know, she has a hit of armor, so he throws the mic before the fireball can be absorbed by the armor, and he gets hit by it. Fantastic.
New tactics.
Yeah. New stuff.
Yep.
All right. Punish.
Oh, wow.
See, so you have to understand, you can't just keep pushing buttons in this game.
Because that's what will happen.
Exactly. You have to understand that sometimes you have to stop.
Yeah, you have to be precise.
Yeah, you have to know what your opponent's going to do. Constantly reading him.
Yeah.
And that heavy kick is not paying off for Ryan. And Z just might take a rock. The uppercut to the eyeballs. And just like that, Mika goes down.
Yeah, showing some signs of life here from Z. He's not out of the fight yet.
Yeah. Ryan, you know, Ryan, I feel like when the standing heavy kick was a little harder to counter before because people didn't know what was going on, that was his go-to.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to realize that don't use it that much.
Yeah.
I mean, it's good, but don't use it all the time.
Ooh, nice.
Nice confirm there. Oh, big damage.
Oh, and he drops it.
And he drops the combo. Wow, and Ryan just back, going right back in. Oh, the dash go.
Hey. He's all triggered up right now.
He's triggered.
Yes, he is.
And okay, Z using this. This is his time.
Oh,
and he got reckless. Standing heavy kick constantly in use has not paid off for Ryan at all.
Right. Oh, nice.
Oh, with Z mounting a comeback.
Yeah,
what is he going to do here?
Z's taking it back to the basics right now. Will it be enough?
Oh. Nadeshko, she's waiting for her chance.
Oh, no. Zeke, totally conflicted right now, has no idea where she came from.
He is confused. Oh, wait. So you're up next against Makito.
Yeah, so I'm up right now. I'll be right back.
What were you going to see? What character?
Me?
Yeah. That Birdman?
Depends. I'll have to think about this.
Okay. All right, guys. So Mike is going to go up to fight Takedo. In case you guys missed it, he got a perfect on Takedo yesterday. Oh, God. Well, hi there, Z. How's
Nadeshiko butt rain that came from the skies, and discussing with Gutex how it is, you know, based on the animation of Armika, which direction he's coming from, is if it's instant.
Yeah, so there's no tell on the direction. Okay. However, there's a tell on whether it will come sooner than later. So if she puts up one hand, it's instant. If she puts up two hands, there's a delay.
But you don't know if it's coming from the side or if it's going to come like acid rain from the top.
You never know.
Okay.
Yeah, you're just going to kind of guess. But the thing was, you know, you were killing him with fireballs, and I noticed that he kept trying to do that charged heavy kick.
Yeah, and it wouldn't go through.
Well, it doesn't go through. It doesn't have projectile invincibility. But I knew that you were getting complacent with throwing the fireballs, and eventually he would call him Deshko and you would
lose.
That's
why we need commentary over the mic so I could hear it.
Okay, so Takedo was talking to me. He said he feels he understands Nash extremely well. But he understands.
Oh my goodness! Did he just put the rubber red boots on him from the skies?
Yeah, he put them from the top down.
Oh, nice evasion.
Okay, so Mike using that birdie. This is easily his best character.
Yeah.
He loves the character. He thinks the character is quite fun.
So Takedo understands the character, but does he have a grasp of the game system? So you're having a nice heart-to-heart with him.
Well, he was asking, he said, based on my playstyle, what do you think I should play? And I said, hey, I think you should play Ryu, actually, because you understand fireballs and frame traps. And Ryu's pretty nasty in this game at that. And he said, oh, okay. But he doesn't know the optimal combos, so he's a little weary of using him. Whereas, he understands Nash because they played him on all the betas.
Right.
But at the same time, he would rather not play
Nash. Can he cancel in time?
No, it's not far. It's not close enough, I mean.
I think a lot of players have been influenced by Infiltration Stream and him on his Nash, and a lot of strategies are developed just from watching that. So I don't know if Takedo is inspired in part by that.
Well, I mean, what I would recommend for everybody who is learning this game...
Yes, diagnose us, Dr. Street Fighter V.
And I would tell them... Yeah, whatever these guys are doing is interesting, but try to kind of establish your own game. You know?
Use your creativity, yes.
Yeah, because a lot of what they're doing is right in their mind, but it may not be right for you. So anyhow, just like that, Takedo takes the second round. I was thinking it was looking a little hopeless for him, but nope, he is going in on Mike.
Oh, that looked like a punch.
And he's about to hit the critical art. So you know that when he does the that move, the moonsault,
yep.
It has no invincibility frames whatsoever, so you could totally
anti-air
it on reaction, 100%
It
of
doesn't
the time.
Look like you can anti-air it, but you really can.
Oh, it's like Jaguar kick
from Aeon?
Yeah, but not as good. Oh, and Mike was trying to catch a backdash with the roundhouse kick?
Oh.
That was a hard read. But this is looking scary.
Nice evasion.
Super, yeah, with a critical art. Skip to my chain, and now Mike has a full V trigger.
Oh,
and he's just a little too early.
What? Double overhead.
You know, what I really like is just how tense everything gets when, you know, your life is low.
Because there's no trip damage. You have to make a correct read at the end, unless you have a super.
Well, there's that, but, you know, there's no real... It's like, how do you create space? You can't backdash, right? So now it's like you have to block, and you have to hope that the attacks push you out. And things like that. And I find that so entertaining. The tension at the very end.
This game, it really comes down to reads. And I am one of the Street Fighter 4 players that have been revealed, exposed into the naked sun at this iteration of the game. So it's very embarrassing for me. I have no option selects for which to hide under and cover my weak points. The Yomi, my weak Yomi.
So pretty much this game has shown that you are actually illiterate when it comes to Street Fighter.
I am.
That you don't have any reads. I understand, Z.
But because I can put my pride aside, I'm going to start from anew. It's like getting a born-again Christian. I will baptize myself into training mode and learn how to fight
in the fires of five.
Yes.
Baptize yourself in the fires of five, man. Awesome.
No, it really does feel that way. So I hope, you know, in this year's Capcom Cup, there would be some fresh faces that we've never seen before. Partially because of all the new blood that's coming in, but also because some of the old players can't rely and rest on their laurels from 4 and bring it in directly into 5.
Yeah, and you know, I feel like there are going to be faces from the Street Fighter 3 world and,
okay,
you know, the kind of, maybe even the older world who are ready to cause trouble. They're just waiting for their turn, you know? They couldn't do it with 4 because the game got extremely complex. But now they're ready.
The OGers are going to be 16ers.
Yeah, they're going to have their kids with them when they go to play sessions and such. You know, it's going to be crazy. Anyhow, right now, Mike turning the tables. Did you see how he got rushed down so hard in that first round?
Yeah.
And he just turned it all around.
He needs to fight. So he's been dealing a lot of...
Wow, and here it is. Big damage.
Whoa.
Big damage. And Taquito still has the V-trigger left. So he can hit a pretty nasty V-trigger combo if he comes here.
Oh, the shenanigans. The first time he used it in an offensive capacity, but he's dead now.
So I don't like that there from Mike.
Using the meter to get that round?
I don't like that because he could have done standing medium punch into EX headbutt and he could have got the knockout. But because he was so worried about connecting it,
He blew his load
he
on the super
did.
Meter.
But then again, you know, in this game,
you get meter
like nobody's business. Yeah. So go ahead and use it. Use the V-trigger, use the critical arts, use it all.
What? The reads? No, Mike is feeling himself. I love that.
And
wow, he is.
And Mike doesn't even care.
Swinging the chains.
Yeah, swinging that chain.
It is difficult for... Oh, nice.
And this is it. Looking back. Oh, nice from Taquito!
Caught him but drinking that can of Red Bull.
He doesn't quite have a full... There it is. Critical art. Bam. Judgment. Saber. Alright, so Mike Ross going down game 2. Taquito, man. You know what I really like about that is that he just never gives up.
He seems like he's impervious to the effects of jet lag. What is going on? This man came fresh from Tokyo. I wonder if Mike has what it takes to bring out... Oh, I guess we won't see the Taquito Ryu that you had suggested to him.
No, it's much too soon. And plus, he did win. Yeah, so he's stuck.
Look at the usual smile on Mike has been wiped out of his face.
He knows a lot's on the line here, right? If he loses to Taquito, who's only been playing for 15 minutes,
yeah.
It just wouldn't be a good look. So
he doesn't have the roommate advantage that Mike has. The roommate privilege.
What is that?
Top roommate
privilege. I don't understand what you're referring
actually,
to.
Actually, he does. Taquito, I think, rooms with Bonchan.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
If I'm not mistaken.
Wow, and Mike with a bad anti-air, missing the down medium punch. But Taquito not stopping.
What is going on? Look at that.
Stun?
I think he's found the weakness.
Oh,
in,
almost stun.
Mike's. Oh, there it is. My overhead
wow.
From stun.
Is he going to get that perfect big damage?
Yes. He's finding that perfect spot where Mike can't anti-air with low medium punch. He's jumping right on his head. Oh my. That was
an expose. That was an expose,
with
ladies
that,
and gentlemen.
That French asterisk at the end? The expose?
Okay. And that's what Mike needed to start the round off pretty nice. But he misses the jump in. Weak. Okay. Just like that.
Oh, my goodness.
Mike with the hard reads. He knows what Taquito wants to do.
Oh!
I like Taquito using the V-trigger when he has it. You know, people shouldn't wait to use their V-trigger. Use it when the opportunity presents itself.
Yeah, instead of waiting when you're in the corner, and that's very predictable, and you're...
Or when the game's almost over, right?
Mm-hmm.
You want it, or when the round is almost over, I should say.
Okay.
Oh, and it's coming down to the wire, guys.
Does that can ever disappear, or it rolls the entire length of the screen?
It goes forever until
My
it touches
goodness.
You.
My goodness.
And because it's so low,
yeah.
It's hard to trade the rhythm.
There's an anti-air. So he can't jump in at that angle. Taquito has to be wary of that the next time he goes in.
Yeah.
Final round. Fight.
That dive is so ridiculous.
He's like, itadakimasu! Here I go! Oh!
And apparently counter? You can guide the length of that dive move. Right?
Yes, if you hold it forward, he mm-hmm. goes a little bit more forward. If you hold back, he reduces his traveling distance.
I think Mike used the maximum length of that.
Okay.
Nice dash. We're gonna switch nice sides.
And just like that, he might...
Mm.
He looks like he's bringing it back. This is actually really close.
Again, that crescent kick. Okay, so Mike has exposed the non-invincibility. Oh my goodness!
And
he can't get a sip!
Oh my gosh, and Mike still doesn't learn. I think Tokido's gotten a lot of damage off that.
Dude,
punishing the V-skills every time.
Kanzuki Uh-oh. Chainsaw Massacre.
Uh-oh.
And Mike, look at the pressure, look at
Mike
the pressure.
Might be out.
Oh no, wait.
What is gonna go?
But he does have a bunch of resources. Will he activate the trigger? And
wow.
he tried the anti-air, and somehow Tokido found the perfect angle for
but did
that
he,
jumping roundhouse.
But did he do a standing medium punch? It looked like a standing,
okay.
not a crouching. I think he didn't get the crouch.
This is salty, man. Let's hear his thoughts.
Ooh, this game just brings out the salt out of everybody. Hi, Mike. Welcome back.
It's getting serious over here.
Is it?
It's getting a little intense over here. And I'm starting to feel the pressure under the spotlights. Get a little warmer when I'm playing now.
This is just
Tokido got me.
It's just
got
an exhibition.
Me.
This is just fun.
He got me.
Alright, so I hope we don't have two Chun-Lis, since Justin and Ricky happen to always play the same characters every time they play. Oh, we have Karin. So Karin has not been seen by many people. This will be exciting. And we have Justin playing Chun, who he swears is the number one character in the game.
Round one. Fight.
Yeah.
Ooh, and just like that, Ricky is in! Ricky with the traps! And Ricky going to work. She knows what's up. Okay. Justin, though, no slouch. Standing light kicks for days. Oh, block your head. Oh, and just like that, Ricky pushing Justin to the corner and throws herself in the corner. Nice.
Let's go, Justin!
Big damage!
Justin Wong.
Oh! No!
Oh my goodness!
you know it's hype when he could just keep walking back.
That
and
was
forth.
It. I almost lost my lunch on that one. Oh!
Oh! Not
footsie
through the door.
God.
Gosh.
Justin Wong with
and
first.
You see, Justin showing why Chun-Li is the best.
Yes.
Ooh, okay, just like that. Ricky pushing Justin to the corner.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't know if I like that ender. That heavy Mugen Kaku.
Right.
We'll see.
Okay. Ooh, nice. See a little bit of that footwork?
I want to see Ricky do more sweeps, less crouching medium kicks.
Yeah, with
Karin.
Karin, yes.
Karin.
There it is.
Uh-oh. Oh, okay. What
yeah,
do we
her
have?
Sweep and is so good.
You see Ricky just trying to push Justin's body to the corner
yep.
as fast as she can.
Yeah.
Say ya.
Okay. Oh,
oh no.
No,
and Justin holding down
yeah.
for some reason. Wow, and Justin missing so many things. Wow, and Ricky,
nice block.
Ricky is getting a lot of value out of that the heavy Mugen
Kaku. Yeah. Good block from the overhead. Oh, wow, again.
How is Justin constantly getting that?
Not too sure exactly what he's going for there, but.
Those terror. Cool.
Yeah.
I think he's holding down unnecessarily.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Oh, wow.
And just like that, we have a 40% lead right here.
Oh.
About 35%.
Yeah. Did a lot.
Oh, sweeps. Footsies. Oh, and Chun-Li pushes her back. You see Karin just controlling
yeah.
everything. Dashing in and out.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Nice.
Justin won.
Oh. Justin Wong fighting his way out of the corner. Yeah, Justin doesn't have any resources right now, so he's going to have to work pretty hard on this comeback.
All right, let's see. And just like that, Ricky, with the pressure.
Yes.
She knows what's up.
Yeah. Oh, there it is. Yeah.
Not quite over, but
yep.
There it is. Mm. Bam, the throw. And Justin... Justin's going to have to think about that. He's going to have to put the stick to neutral.
Yes.
So that he doesn't get EX spinning birds.
Mm.
After the crouching medium kick. Just let the stick hit neutral.
Okay.
And it will negate the charge.
Hoping those words came across.
Actually, so I hear that there's no in-house commentary this time, so I don't think he's heard anything that I've said. Oh, there is in-house commentary? You guys are hearing me? Yeah.
Loud and clear.
Yeah, let them know. I'm giving all kinds of tips, guys. Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah. So you heard everything I was saying about you when you was playing?
No. It's too intense over there. Can't hear nothing. Yeah.
Man.
When you're in the hot seat.
Oh, okay.
You don't get to hear anything.
Man, you know what the winner of this gets?
What's up?
They get the entire
catalog
of MadCatz products that are being displayed here today. So there's quite a bit on the line.
Oh my goodness.
Good job on not getting first, Mike.
How come they should have relayed that message to me beforehand?
Oh, you didn't know?
You know?
No, I thought that was common knowledge.
You know? The entire catalog?
All right, so Justin playing a little bit differently. So, you know, this is vintage. This is vintage Jay right here.
Yeah, it is.
For all of you guys, he has the space and control.
That's what he's doing.
Yeah, but Ricky's always had that as well. So you're seeing in a true exhibition of footsies.
Yes.
Ooh. Footsies.
Round two. Fight.
Justin now adjusting his game to play. Oh no, never mind. Ricky doing a great job applying that pressure, moving Justin back at the start of every fight. Oh jeez,
it's a big damage. Mew Jin Kyaku for the corner push. Look at this guy.
Okay, there he goes. That's what you wanted to see.
Oh.
Abusing that sweep, and sure enough, Ricky did.
And you know, Justin never does wake up the EX spinning bird.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because that's one of those things that would get you killed if
nice.
Oh, we could have seen something so wicked there.
Nice, and Ricky grabs the round.
Do you think Ricky's confirming that? Or is she just doing it?
I'm pretty sure these are... I'm going to give the benefit of the doubt. These are definitely confirms here.
Okay.
Definitely some confirms.
Ooh, a sweet. And the legs. The legs.
Ooh. That was actually ridiculous. The dash and then dash back at the last second. Crouching medium.
There you go. That's like really punishable.
Yeah.
So, you know, one of Curry's weaknesses is her anti-air game isn't the hottest. Wow, standing short crouching.
Yeah, this is ridiculous. Look at that.
Justin.
Her movement right now is ridiculous.
That throw, though. And Justin on the verge of bringing it back. But if Ricky gets a touch in, she wins the game.
Yeah. Justin has a little V trigger left, and that might be. That's enough damage.
No, I don't think it is.
I think it is.
I don't think it is.
Oh, okay. It definitely was.
I thought she was going to survive.
It definitely
was. I thought she was going to survive by
1%. No. Oh.
And just like that, an EG team kill? What? In an exhibition? That's crazy. And Justin is salty.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
So we have my pick. You know, it might as well be me up there playing my doppelganger.
Same thing. Can't really tell the difference.
Yeah. Buttons per minute. You know what I wish?
That BPM?
I want him to play and to have all the... I want him to have all the commands on display.
Yeah, the action
so
data.
You can see this guy go to work, okay, guys? You can see him go to work.
You know it's serious.
I'm like, I just decided to randomly hop in the chat.
Yeah.
Just
real quick. Oh no! Don't read what.
Why did I do that?
What are the monsters telling you?
No, I'm just saying hi, guys. Saying hi for everybody tuning in.
Oh man.
What do we have here? 15K viewers. Hey, thanks for tuning in, guys. Watch LPN go to work. That bird. that birdie.
Oh, he's rocking birdie?
Yeah, actually, he has a really good birdie.
Oh, okay.
Awesome.
You can I'm gonna take notes. Anytime LPN's on the sticks, I always grab out my pen and paper.
Round one.
All right, so LPN, what does he have in store?
Okay, let's see this.
That's what he has, that soda can.
Nice. And
just
this is
like
flow.
That, he got bopped. Why did I put him in? I just turning on him. Didn't even give him a chance, yeah. Guys. Oh, just diving in.
Oh,
dizzy.
Oh, LPN.
Oh, he
doesn't. LPN is a.
Why is he playing such an aggressive
He's
birdie?
Relentless. He's relentless.
I didn't see Mike do any of that. I didn't see Mike do none of that.
Well, I also played against a tough opponent such as Tokido and Walmart. Filipino champ. They didn't really give me a chance to do any of that.
Oh, look at that on reaction.
Oh, no.
Oh. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Why doesn't LPN know? I mean.
Oh, nice.
He lives the beta, guys.
He does.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Oh, no, nothing.
Oh, that could have been a good punish.
Yeah.
But Flo didn't get the close standing medium.
That's right.
Which is what he wanted.
Nice.
Nice reactions from Flo here. What is he going
to
do here?
Ooh. Flo's beginning to believe.
The push.
Nice.
Oh
wow. Nice. That was actually pretty sick from LPN.
Oh, and LPN could have ended the round there if the jab connected.
Yeah.
Wow, nice jump.
Oh, no. Flo tried to survive, but he couldn't. He just didn't have the life.
But the kicks didn't even connect. Yeah. They like flew right over his head. And Birdie's a tall character, dude. Look at that. Oh,
yeah, that was
God.
Beautiful.
And just right.
Nice succession of attacks right there from LPN.
I was told that's very reactable. That EX.
Yes.
That EX Avenger move from Birdie, that's reactable. In my mind, you are getting thrown.
Once you look at it, it's already too late.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you're already late.
You're already getting grabbed, right?
Birdie already swam right to his destination. Wherever that may be.
And Flo is just
like... You can just look at the disgust on Flo's face right now. He's just disgusted.
Well, it's funny because, I mean, if I was up there, he'd have the exact same face. So
this is true.
Yeah.
Might be... I feel you.
Alright.
Round one.
Fight. Oh, yes, this is going
there
to be.
There it is.
I was ready for something exciting there.
That was really good job. Really good work. Good job, production team.
Oh, Footsie, stop it. Oh, you're not going under the feet.
Huh?
Uh oh, there it is.
There it is. Yeah,
don't
you cannot react to that.
Up quickly. Oh, two low jabs, stop it. Oh, nice. Now Flo potentially out. And why did he do a command throw from that far? Who knows?
I just don't know why he's using Chun-Li. I don't know why Flo is using Chun-Li.
Well, she's the best character in the game.
But that's not his best character.
Oh.
Or is it? Are we seeing the best display?
Well, you know, I was saying earlier to... Filipino champ and PR Rog and those guys.
Yeah.
I was saying it's gonna be funny because everybody's going to like play every character and they're gonna learn them and all that, and then they're gonna psych themselves out and say, "Oh, this is a good matchup. I'll play X character."
Yep.
And then they're gonna shortchange themselves because you should play the character you're the best at.
Yeah, exactly.
Like I feel like Flo, clearly Chun-Li is not his best character. We're seeing it first time.
Oh, nice. Flo, what are you doing?
Flo missing the cancel on the first pierce.
Oh. Excellent usage of V-Trigger there by LPN.
I don't think that's how Flo wanted to make his debut.
That's pretty impressive for, you know, his time with Beta. That's awesome skills.
Oh, dude.
Shout out to LPN.
Yeah, dude, LPN, incredible. Incredible. With his measly 4 hours of Beta playtime. He's shown us so much.
Yeah,
so quick.
A lot of new combos, a lot of V trigger. Wait, who's next? We need Gutex versus Tokido.
Yeah, Gutex versus Tokido. We're at the final four.
Okay.
We're at the final four, ladies and gentlemen. This is going to be interesting.
Yes, it will be. Who will come out on top?
So I feel like Gutex definitely has a chance here.
Yes, he
does.
But
he has to play it really slow because. I don't think that Tokido is very familiar with Mika.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I feel like Gutex will also have to be on point to stop the jumps. Because, you know, you weren't able to stop his jumps.
No.
And that's...
I wasn't able to stop anybody's jumps.
That's what your downfall was.
Yes.
Right?
Correct. Especially at the end there when you jumped at me and I did standing medium punch instead of crouching medium punch.
Exactly, and that's what I said.
I was like, oh my gosh, I got the wrong one out, so... And it cost me everything.
It cost me my whole career. It cost you the whole catalog.
That's right, yeah, it literally did.
You know what you'll be playing on, Mike? PS4 pets.
Yeah. You're right.
Oh, wow.
Shout out to Nasser. Wherever he went, he's gone.
Wow. So, we're waiting for Ryan. I don't know where
he's
at.
Right. We need a Gutex.
Oh, there he comes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just had to give the right call out.
Yeah, exactly. He was like, who's Ryan?
Yeah.
Who's Gutex? But Gooey?
Yeah, there he is. It just pops up. Say his name 3 times in the mirror.
Oh, and there are some salt monsters in the room right now. You guys can't see them behind the camera, ladies and gentlemen. But there are some very, very salty.
The salt is a flowing right now.
Yeah.
No pun intended.
Yeah.
Let it flow, let it flow, let it flow.
We'll kill you.
That was good.
Yeah.
That was really good. That was really good, Peter.
This is the path of my destiny.
All right. Oh, and Gutex is opting to go with Ryu on this match.
He's staying solid.
Yes.
He's staying. Oh, and just like that. Tokido said, give me that.
Oh, wow.
And look at that. The V gauge is filling up.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but I like Ryan hitting that strong uppercut. I felt that challenge was good.
Yes.
And this is Ryan knows the character.
This is the character he probably should be playing in this game.
Ryan does have fundamentals.
Yes.
Okay, but he mistimed that parry.
Yes, he did. Oh, wow. Everybody heard that parry.
Yeah, I really don't like Tokido's use of the crouch medium kick.
Mm,
nice block.
Really?
That block was important. That V reversal, not so much.
Mm. Well, he did get Tokido in the corner. Now it's his time to play.
Oh, and then there he goes. Oh, punished. No hurricane.
No hurricane,
kick.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Get the damage every time. Don't miss it. I feel like the Sonic Boom is a bait.
Yeah, it is.
He's baiting him to parry so he can punish.
Exactly. Don't get distracted by it.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
No.
Late V-reversal.
Bad V-reversal. And I think that's the round for Tokido.
Mm.
Oh, no.
Oh, wow. No, he's still holding on by a thread.
Ryan has a chance. Don't get reckless, Ryan.
Oh, no.
Why?
Mistimed a parry, which a parry was not even necessary at that point.
Well, I think he tried to jump, but he decided to jump too late.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so right now, Tokido, one step ahead of Ryan, it seems.
Oh.
I think Ryan's playing a little too cautiously.
Yes.
And that's allowing Tokido to get in really quickly with Dash.
Giving him that big boot right there. Oh, nice DP.
There it is. He
had to challenge
risked it.
Yep.
He risked it all.
Sometimes you have to.
Oh, I thought that was going to be
a
regular jump. Man, and Tokido hitting all the right buttons.
Nice. Tokido's definitely stepped it up from yesterday morning, I'll say.
Oh, yeah. You know, he has been practicing.
Yeah, he's starting to get more comfortable with the mobility in this game.
Ooh, and I think Ryan needs to watch out because I feel like that V-trigger is going to come out at any time from Tokido. When he gets 75% of that last gauge, he's going to do it randomly.
Like that? Just
yeah,
like you said?
Exactly.
Wow.
Well, that wasn't random. He kind of did it on a punish.
Right, yeah. But you kind of said when it was coming.
Yeah. I mean, you kind of tell. He's like, I'm almost there.
Yep.
I'm almost going to make it.
Yeah, look at it. Look at Tokido's meter. Perfect.
Right
on the hit. Perfectly got the meter right on the hit. Shout out to Segley on the behind the replay board.
Alright, well, I think Gutex, he just needs to know when to turn it on and be a little bit more aggressive.
Yes.
He's playing so passive. He's letting Tokido dash in, dash out, hit his buttons.
Exactly.
Challenge this man. Challenge him.
Okay, so here we go.
Let's see what adaptations have been made, if any.
Round one.
So far, Torpedo has absorbed one of Ryan's fireballs at the start of every round. Oh no, he's going
and
straight in this time.
No pun. Wow, yeah. Man. And I think Ryan missed a uppercut
did.
There.
Yeah, he definitely did.
And he's missing. You know, every time he hits a low strong, he should do the hurricane kick. Mm. Just go for it, man.
Yeah.
Obvious.
Yeah, that was
Saw obvious. I think we all could say the same.
That's right.
There's every time
bad V reversal.
That forward and heavy punch always comes after a sonic boom.
Yeah.
Just parry that. That's what the parry's for.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, nice from Ryan.
Very good. Good damage.
Nice neutral jump.
Yep.
Oh, whoa. Oh, okay. Challenged.
No.
Obvious.
Yeah, that.
And there
I'll tell
it
you,
is.
One thing that doesn't really work as effectively in this game is the simple jab tick bro.
Exactly.
It's pretty obvious when it's coming.
Obvious. Yeah, you gotta be able to walk in and walk out.
Yeah.
Be like Houdini.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh. Okay.
Nice. Boom. There's that throw. Okay. And look at that. You see that Tokido has a full gauge now.
That's right.
You know he's ready to just hit that Sonic Sight.
Yes, yeah, at any moment. And Ryan is looking out for that as well. He's kind of afraid of it.
All right, so boom, just like that, right? Oh, you can't just go in like that.
Exactly. He was waiting for it.
You have to assume that this dude's going to wake up with a button.
All right. Oh, no.
And that's what Tokido needed.
Oh, so tricky. You don't really know what side he's going to land on.
That's such big damage. You know, all Ryan has to do is hit jab. He just has to hit jab when Nash goes into the air.
To contest it.
Yes.
Okay.
If he reacts in time.
Yeah, I don't like the use of that EX fireball. It's totally unnecessary.
Exactly. Meter management, guys, in this game is very important.
Oh, this
is big damage. Oh, but Tokido does not know the crush counter combos, so Ryan lives another day.
Oh, no.
Uppercut.
Good GP.
Do not let him jump.
Yep.
And that V trigger is almost full, so make sure you keep your eye on it because he's going to activate.
You know what the problem is right now is I'm not seeing enough buttons from Gutex.
He's playing two reserve, is that what you're saying?
Yes.
And here's he's gonna do it shortly.
Yeah.
Don't throw a fireball. Oh, and that's it!
Oh, nice.
Now Gutex has a chance.
Ooh, very good from Gutex.
Oh, just keep rushing. Uh-oh, watch out though. He has a critical art.
Yeah, he does.
Nice.
Well placed DP right there. He maintained his composure and pulled through when it mattered.
There you go. Ryan, digging deep.
Yes.
Digging deep.
You know, Tokido told me as soon as he sat down, he said, "You beat me yesterday, I beat you today."
Oh, that's what he said?
That's what he said to me. He said, "You beat me yesterday, I beat you today."
Wow. and he said it before he did
it. See, and everybody just sees that nice, innocent smile. They don't think he's talking trash. Oh, he's talking up there.
Oh, he's probably the most trash talking player from the Orient that I know.
Don't be fooled by the smile.
Yeah, actually, him and Mago, man, they let you know. They let you know if they think you ain't that good. Yeah, so alright. We got game three, it's 1-1.
Here we go.
And let's see. So Gutex had some pretty good changes in his game. He played a lot more solid.
Yeah, he
and
did.
He went in a little bit more.
Yes.
And that's what he needed to do.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Wow,
nice. Just like that.
Tokido.
Chasing the sonic boom.
He's out for blood. He's out for blood right now.
Walk the dog. And just like that, Ryan needs a little bit of pressure.
Mm-hmm. That's. I thought we were going to get close to Dizzy here. Yes, we are.
And how did Ryan. What is Ryan doing on his cycle? A perfect. That looks familiar. And man.
Yes, it does.
Tokido taking names. He doesn't even need MadCatz products, man. He's sponsored.
But he's trying to get him. He's trying to get him.
Oh, wow. Meaty down fierce. Why?
Okay.
Nice.
Oh, very good air throw from Tokido.
Oh,
that would have been crazy.
Oh, but we don't get the biggest punish possible.
Brian leaving damage on the tip.
Oh!
No, okay!
He saw it.
Oh, wow. Nice reaction
and
from Tokido.
Tokido saw that. They are going back and forth right now, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, no!
Why?
Oh, he fortunately didn't get punished.
Okay, what is Ryan gonna do here?
Okay, footsies! You guys are seeing him here first.
Oh, DP! Yes! Ryan playing clean! Somehow keeping himself in the game!
Yeah, he is!
Oh, obvious stop.
Oh, wow. Tokido's fighting back. And he's sitting on that V-trigger.
Oh.
Wow.
And he...
Oh, no! And that was it. He dashed right into Tokido's hands.
That could be it. Down fierce, uppercutted, standing jab.
Anything.
Yeah, it doesn't
not
have
invisible.
Any invincibility. But it still catches everyone off guard.
It does. I was about to say, it's sneaky.
Yeah, I agree.
It's not that obvious.
I agree. I'll stop acting like,
yeah,
you know.
Man. Please.
Yeah. You guys don't work on the game. I understand.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Wow.
Here we're going to have a little NorCal battle here.
Yeah.
Ricky Ortiz versus LPN.
The battle of the haves and the have-nots. And when I talk about haves, I'm talking about respect. They don't have any for LPN, not yet. He's here to make a name for himself, ladies and gentlemen.
That was genius. That was straight up genius.
All right, so you have LPN playing that birdie.
I'm surprised. I would have figured LPN might play Camier or something. Something a little more...
aggressive?
Yes.
Yeah. But you know, I actually like this pick from him because birdie has pretty good damage output.
Yeah.
And
LPN always gets damage.
That's what he cares about the most.
Oh, no.
Okay, so we're going to see Ricky play those footsies that she is known for. Oh, don't do it. Get caught.
Yep. Kareem.
The damage.
Yes.
Wow, and no punish from LPN on the jump there.
Oh!
Wow, and he's just gonna do stuff.
LPN is... Oh, wow.
Oh, nice. Crush counter. Oh, but you see, Ricky doesn't have a tactic just yet behind that.
Don't think she was ready for it. Oh, nice neutral jump.
Wow, and the can... Oh. The can messing up the command throw shenanigans.
Ooh, nobody... Can't punish that.
And you see And just like that, those Yujin Kyaku's adding up.
Mm-hmm.
Ricky with the pressure. And footsies.
That's right. Oh, wow. And I like
how LPN has touching those feet.
Buttons.
Touch those feet.
Buttons.
Yeah, there it is, the crouch strong. Mm-hmm. And the command throw after, then the EX command throw following that. Oh,
nice.
Oh my goodness, LPN going in?
Yep.
The banana foiling any attempt. LPN, drink that.
I like
meter.
It. I like
Max
it.
Max meter game.
Exactly, took a sip of his beverage, threw it into the combo.
Litter on her, straight litter.
Nice.
Nobody's reacting
to that. Yeah, you're not reacting to that.
You're T-1000 if you're reacting to that. Non-human. Sweep? Oh, no, counter sweep. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And right now, Ricky acting at the wall. Oh, and no V-trigger activation on that. That could have been pretty dastardly. And LPN resetting his dizzy bar, which is why he went away. No punish on that.
Yeah.
This is looking kind of tense.
Uh-oh.
No anti-air, though.
No anti-air again.
Oh, and Ricky missing the combo there. Could have got a critical art. Whoa, chains.
Now he's just...
Chains.
Now he's hoping for something. Okay, he gets it.
Caught Ricky's dash. The banana. Straight three stooges on him.
Nice, and LPN takes the first game.
With the feet, that long range.
We saw a lot of garbage thrown on the floor there.
That long range birdie spin. Pretty good. A solid play there from LPN.
Mm-hmm.
Solid play there. A solid play from both parties, actually.
That's right.
Yeah, but Ricky missed that one combo, and that cost her the game, so she's got to keep her eyes open.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, it's so funny. People are like, oh, execution of this game so easy. Combo so easy. You're still going to lose. You're still going to drop me.
That's right. Yeah, everything, you
you're
know.
You're still going to drop the combo in a tense situation.
Let's see if you can perform that in the heat of the moment.
Exactly. When you have spotlights
in
on
your
you.
Eyes.
Yeah.
In your eyes.
Mike with the accents on words that don't need to have accents. And LPN figuring out, but it's... Ooh, that could have been a bigger punish from Ricky, but yeah,
oh,
she,
nice.
Wanted, she wanted damage.
Mm-hmm. Oh, very
she
good.
She said it all adds up. No, not that EX throw. It's too hard to stop. Uh-oh,
Birdie's
just like
coming.
That. Pressure.
Yeah.
Ricky's being pressured right now.
That's right.
LPN playing an offensive Birdie. Mm-hmm. I think that's a little different than yours.
Absolutely. Yeah, he's right? constantly just going
yeah.
in.
Yeah, I feel like yours is read-based,
yes.
and LPN's is pressure-based.
Yes.
You know.
Which probably works out better for this game, though. That wasn't a reaction. Ricky was already in the air. She knew better.
Yeah. She said, what is this guy going to do? Yes. Oh, crush counter sweep. No!
Oh, no.
That could have been the round. That actually could have been the round had Ricky landed.
Yep.
LPN is ready, guys.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
He is ready. He said, you know, I wasn't able to make a dent in four, you know?
But this is my time. This is my year.
I'm going to shine.
This is my game.
Because now you have to deal with me.
Yes.
You can't backdash.
Yeah.
You can't focus.
That's
me.
Right.
You have to deal with this Tasmanian
yes.
devil
yes.
when he spins and he comes Ooh. Into you with those nuts.
Oh. Wow, nice defense from Ricky here.
Yeah, she is keeping LPN out. She wants no part of that.
Yep.
Footies.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Oh, wow. Nice.
Crouch strong.
Yep. I thought that would kill. Ooh, nice
Ooh,
block.
That was a good block from Ricky.
Ooh, and LPN was just too much for Ricky to handle.
Okay, so LPN moves on. LPN, stay there, my friend. You are going up against... So we have
some words.
Yeah, we have the peanut gallery giving us all kinds of insight into the genius design of five, which I wholeheartedly agree with, my dear.
Of course. All right, well, here we go.
Oh, let's see. And just like that, and LPN creating reaction.
That's right.
Creating predictable actions from Tokido.
Ooh, nice big damage.
Yes,
from Tokido. Oh, stashed right into his hands.
Why is he whiffing throws? The world may never know.
But exactly.
LPN, though, with the life lead.
Ooh, nice.
Reacting well there to Nash's Sonic Boom. Get out the air, you.
Nice, from Tokido.
Tokido, that new meta. The game isn't even out, and he has meta.
Ooh. Oh, wow. Oh, the buttons. The
that
short got him.
Was nice.
I like it.
Red hot chili peppers on
them. Oh! Okay.
And that actually takes away. That actually gives Nash life back when you do the EX
version
of that throw, yeah. Ooh, forward heavies. Let's go.
Oh no, misses the anti air. Big damage, just non-reactable like EX command grab.
Free damage all day. Wow, and he's just
walking man,
out.
Yeah, he's walking him.
Oh, he's so smart. But LPN missing the headbutt there, getting a command throw instead.
Yeah, this is definitely going
to
be...
Did he just react to that?
No, the world will never know. The world will never know.
Yeah.
Oh, and he just got caught. Caught in the grapple.
It's
LPN.
So tense. It's so tense over here.
Yes,
LPN.
It is. LPN leads 1-0 right now. Is he going to...
He's on the verge of taking this, guys.
He's going to take home a lot of MadCatz product if he wins this.
Yeah. And I mean, he, you know, whenever the betas go live, he is playing. So I'm pretty sure he needs all the equipment he can get.
Exactly.
Yeah. One win away, playing so solidly. So I just want to let you know, Mike, if I was up there, the same thing would have happened. So,
oh, really?
He's an extension of me.
Okay. So this is essentially you versus Tokido right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and you guys would have saw plenty of the same.
Well, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Combo Fiend versus Tokido happening right now. Combo Fiend on Birdie. Of course, just doing random stuff in the opener. Much like Combo Fiend.
Why are you discrediting him? He reacted.
Last round, I was saying how sick it was.
Oh, we played like you? Everything sucks.
Exactly. I see now.
And I love the crutch medium punch every time ready. Uh-oh, big damage right there. EX, of course.
Yes.
Of course, because you're not going to get out of it. Get the. Oh. It's delicious. Oh, and nice block of the crouch drop.
Oh, no. There's nowhere you can go.
Don't go to the
air. Can't escape the bird.
Don't go to the air against Birdie.
Yes.
He's so solid.
Exactly. Okay, big damage.
Yes.
Oh no, this
and
is
just
twice.
Like that.
After the double dash, LPN is.
Why is he doing whiff throws? What is that?
I'm just trying to look cute.
This is an Alpha 3. Yeah. We'll go, look at that. That's reaction. Yeah. That's not random, Mike. Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Just. Oh, he's just all over.
Yeah. And he's going to go straight in to get some as much damage as he can right now.
Yeah, and Tokido wants no part of that. He wants out the corner.
Exactly.
And
he needs
wants
time
all the damage
to find some answers.
Oh, wow. Wow, and that is very punishable. But no punish from Tokido. Nice.
Mm-hmm. Take the can. Okay.
Oh, here we go.
This is bad. Oh, wow, okay. Tokido managed to hold on for dear life there.
Well, what was big for them, I mean, for Tokido there, was he got an air recovery.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, and Tokido not jumping anymore. He's had enough.
No, yeah. Oh, spoke a little too soon.
Command throw?
Yes.
Nice backdash from Tokido. He smelt it. Low jab, low jab, low jab.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry, Tokido.
He can't react to that. It's too fast. Oh no, he pressed something.
Uh-oh. This is big. This is good. Tokido.
Oh, Tokido.
Uh-oh. Almost with the stun.
Oh. He finishes him off with a move you just can't react
that
to.
That EX Avenger.
LPN is your exhibition.
So LPN
champion.
Takes the exhibition. Takes home the whole Mad Catz catalog. Doing it.
Yeah, look at this.
And just look at this. This was about to be in Tokido's favor. But see, look, when he re-reversaled, he actually reduced the stun gauge by about 15-20%. That's an instant result of doing that.
As soon as you do the V-reversal.
Yeah,
right?
So you want to make sure that, you know, you keep that in mind. A lot of people might feel the game's a little tense and they might have options when they're in the corner and they're almost dizzy. V-reversals, very important. All right, guys, so that ends our exhibition. I believe we are going to take a short break. And once we finish up with that short break, we're going to come back to the Churning the Butter. And
they
are having their first open Street Fighter V tournament. And these guys are out here. They are hungry. They are wild.
It's going to be nuts.
We'll be back shortly, guys.
All right, sit tight.